Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. Today we will be exploring the Twilight Faron Woods. Oh, and here we have another one of those barriers where we fought this Shadow Beast. And of course, never failing to disappoint, Shadow Beasts. Except this time, there are three of them. That shouldn't be too much more difficult, should it? Hell yeah, we can take them on all at once. Well, it's not like Midna did very much for us in the first place. Well, fighting three at once is a bit more complicated than fighting two at once, because you've got to make sure that one of them doesn't hit you when you are attacking the other. Well, there's also that, I suppose. I wonder how we're going to do this. Hopefully they'll just get tired and give up. Oh, so Midna's actually going to do something for us this time. And that is the new part of our arsenal, the charge attack. It's fairly useful, but it's not the best tool for every situation. And that is a glowing golden mist. Let's go speak to it. I appreciate you looking out for us, but you really haven't told us very much that's new yet. Well, this is new. In order to be able to restore light to the area, we're going to have to collect 16 tiers of light, which are trapped within 16 shadow insects. This is made easy by the fact that the tiers of light are clearly marked upon our map, and only a little bit more difficult by the fact that we can only see and target these insects with our senses active. And there I go, showing you how not to use the charge attack. This is informative, after all. And once you kill each of the Twilight Shadow Insects, that blue light will pop out and will slowly home in on you. As you can see, we can't quite get through the gate, so let's go to the side here where there are a couple of tiers of light and see if we can't find a way through. This guy thinks he's being clever, but, well, he doesn't have that tight a grip on the wall. And that's three down. Let's go check over here and invade Koro's privacy by jumping into his home. Kind of neat that he has a little side balcony, though. Even though it doesn't really look like much of a balcony. Well, since Kuro's busy pissing his pants over these, we'll just quickly deal with them. And even though we got rid of the bugs, that still doesn't change the fact that he is scared and alone. But whatever. We still haven't managed to find a way to open the gate, But maybe if we investigate it closer, we'll find a different way through. As you can see, there's a patch of golden sparkle dirt. And with that, we are past the gate. And I thought I hit at least one of those with that charge attack. But as you can see, when you're not using it on a full-sized monster, it is a bit more fickle. Well, say what you will about the color oversaturation that is indicative of being in an area bathed in twilight, it certainly makes seeing in this cave area a lot easier, which is nice because we don't have access to our lantern. Anyway, there isn't too much special going on here, just twilight versions of all the enemies that are normally in here. And you'll find that'll be standard fare for pretty much any area that we visit, with only a few exceptions. And as you can also see, the charge attack does not work on inanimate objects, but we still do spin attack when we charge up for that circle attack. This is a pretty ominous new addition to this neck of the woods. Well, there's only one way to see what this poison mist will do to us. And the answer is it won't do anything except spit us back out onto land. So that is a pretty annoying way to block our progress forward, but nothing we can't overcome. Flying shadow insects are no match once they get down to our level, but they are a pain in the ass when they are not at our level. And over here, we've got more jumping. Now here you're going to want to be careful that you hurry up through there, because if you're not fast, then the shadow keys will attack you and knock you into the mist. And that is not quite fun. And with these three tiers of light, we've only got four more left. So let's continue on with our jumping puzzles. As you can see, the Deku Babas will also attack you if you're not careful. So you'll want to have a nice rhythm with your A button presses. And of course, you want to watch out for that vine log there. But this is the last of the jumping puzzle. So let's go see what's buried there, shall we? How nice that they both came out with just one digging. It certainly makes things more convenient. And that's only two more to go. Let's continue forward. More of these bastards, huh? Well, let's see if we can't get them all in just one attack. Gotta get these two guys to pay attention to us. And just a little bit out of the radius of the circle, but that's fine. So long as you're almost within a radius, you shouldn't have too much problems keeping them both, or keeping all three of them electrified with your targeting magic. And here are the last two of the shadow insects. Let's make this quick. I wonder if that is the same monkey that we helped earlier. And what do you know? I think it is. Yes, not even the animals can see you if they are spirits. And that is the last of the Tears of Light, and we get automatically transported to this cutscene.